Will all these new electric cars crash the power grid? Well, I'll explain. First, we had high temperatures, which increased the demand for electric power on air conditioning. And then we had computers and electric car charging. And all this together could possibly crash the grid. Now, the latest dose of reality came this week when California was facing triple digit temperatures, which began to worry a lot of the power authority because the power grid was being strained. And if everyone started charging at once, this became a problem. But this is not just a California problem. It impacts the entire United States, and we're starting to see the results of relying on 100% solar and wind and reduced nuclear, natural gas, and coal usage. And I promise you this, it's going to lead to increased costs for electricity, and I'll explain. Welcome back to the channel, I'm Lauren Fix. If this is your first time here, we give you more than car reviews and first looks at new vehicles. We give you car smarts because knowledge is power. Make sure to subscribe and click that little bell so you don't miss anything. California literally just told everyone to not charge their electric cars due to a power shortage. And on June 18th, there was a post on Facebook, and this year, the scorching temperatures arrived early, prompting the first power conservation advisory of the summer on June 17th, setting off speculation on social media about how the heat could impact electric car owners. And this sparked some serious discussion on social media about whether California has the resources to continue this massive push forward on electric vehicles in pursuit of a greener future. Now, currently, California is planning to be only all electric cars by 2035. For California, it can't provide enough electricity for their homes and businesses, yet they're mandating that everyone drive more electric cars. But this electric grid issue impacts other states. Look at Texas, who recently was in darkness for weeks. This is a state that is known for oil and gas, and they tried changing their base load power to wind and solar and reducing the load on natural gas and coal. The Energy Board was humiliated, and many of them stepped down. This was a bad decision that impacted many people's lives. Now, New York City, Seattle, and Portland, there are large cities also that are having similar problems, not just with electric cars, but high temperatures and electricity. And they're telling everyone to shut off their air conditioning, unplug unused electric appliances. The demand has increased and the supply isn't as reliable as it could be, and you certainly can't rely on wind and solar. Charging at night doesn't necessarily work for everyone. So what is the impact to you and your wallet? There's more car smarts in my book, Lauren Fix's Guide to Loving Your Car. The link is down below. The grid has problems that are greater than electric cars. The grid needs to be upgraded by adding on the load from electric cars and not powering by just solar and wind, because that's not enough and the draw is too great. And if every car were to plug in all at once, we definitely can't meet that electric need. There is a theory that people will plug in only at night. But in Silicon Valley, every office has charging at their office as a benefit to their employees. So people charge at work for free and don't plug in at home. And it's just more convenient that way. But the best conditions are for charging for people at home instead of it being easier for charging at work. Now, every car added to the system during the day puts a load on their base load and taxes the system because companies, homes, and universities use quite a bit of power during the day. Increasing the supply of energy is not the answer. The grid needs to be upgraded, and to increase the capacity will cost trillions of dollars. The Energy Marketers of America, EMA, stated that if 10% of America goes to electric vehicles, the cost will be $147 billion, and that cost will be passed down to you. Electric companies are calling us ratepayers, and they're charging us for that subsidy whether you use it or not, and we're all paying for it with increased prices. And utility companies are seeking approval to charge ratepayers additional money to pay for the build-out of these electric vehicle charging infrastructure, even though that same infrastructure is going to become a source of revenue for those utilities down the road. According to a recent EMA study, building out the EV charging infrastructure, just the charging port, not the additional electricity on the grid or weatherizing them, will cost more than $5,000 for every electric vehicle, and that cost is back on you. There are some other options to reduce the carbon footprint, and it's not part of the Green New Deal. Nuclear power is a clean and sustainable, and nuclear is a zero emissions clean energy source, but it's not subsidized, and removing it from the grid causes brownouts, and we're already seeing this in California and in New York City. There's also new fracking techniques that could be used to generate energy with no carbon emissions. Here's the bottom line. In the nation's capital and state capitals around the country, laws and regulations are being pursued by the ultimate goal of getting rid of gasoline and diesel-fueled cars and trucks. These policies come in many different packages with many different names, such as the infrastructure bill, zero emissions vehicles mandates, fuel economy standards, clean car and truck rules, low carbon fuel standards. But what they share is the central goal of making it more expensive to own any vehicle that isn't electric and requiring the public rather than the private companies to pay for electric vehicle charging. Already, these government approaches are hitting American drivers. All consumers need to be informed, and policymakers need to take steps to insert consumer protections into each of these measures. There's a push for electric vehicles. And are we moving too fast? And is the cost to you going to increase so the price of gasoline is also going to increase? Well, they're putting the squeeze on us. Be aware. If you got value from this video, give it a like and subscribe for more videos like this one. If you have any questions or comments, and I'm sure you do, put it in the comments down below. I'll be happy to answer and, of course, comment back. And I'll be putting more on my social media on all platforms at Lauren Fix. I also put out best prices and some cool new vehicles coming out. And there's more on our website, carcoachreports.com. It's in English and in Spanish. And if you haven't had a chance to hear our podcast, Total Car Score, we've got some pretty cool content there. It's on all platforms. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.